channel, The Baking Diva. And once again, a big shout out to all my subscribers. For those of you that are new to my channel, my name is Dolores, and I'm better known as The Baking Diva. Well, Easter is a week from today, so I'm trying to get a lot of my Easter goodies made. I have 1 week to do it. So I've had a little bit of an issue here. My son installed one of those automatic lights that go on and off in the backyard. Well, my bedroom is in the back and it has a big picture window. And every darn night, in the middle of the night, the lights come on out there. And I'm like, what is going on? So the other night they came on, I don't know, it was about 3 a.m. and I said, what the heck? So I tiptoed over, it's a big picture window, peeked out there, and who did I see? A bunny. And it wasn't just any bunny, it was the Easter bunny. Oh my gosh, look it, in the back of my yard. He's peeking from behind the tree. Oh my God, what a little sneak that bunny. Oh my gosh, look at him. I'm gonna get him with my bunny bait. And he was like, I think he was scoping the neighborhood. I'm not sure, maybe to figure out where to hide eggs on Easter. And I caught him. He was big and white and I caught him shooting right through my backyard and he put the lights on. I said to my son, no, you didn't do anything wrong. No, it's the bunny. So I'm determined to catch that bunny or at least to find out the heck he's doing in my yard every night. So today I'm gonna make for you what I call bunny bait. And you know what bait is, like you put bait on the end of your hook when you go fishing to catch the fish. Well, this is gonna be bunny bait and I'm gonna catch that darn bunny. Sorry for these glasses. My eye doctor appointment is Thursday. I'm sure be getting new ones. But anyway, this goes by other names. I have one similar to this that I make at Christmas. I call it my White Christmas holiday mix. Some people make one not exactly like this, but similar, and they call it white trash. So everybody has their own little version, but today I'm gonna make that bunny bait and I'm gonna catch that bunny. I'm gonna put a bowl of it out on my dessert table for Easter, and then I'm gonna put another little dish out on my patio, and I'm gonna see if I catch that little bugger. Oh my God, look at him! Looking through my front window! Oh my gosh! Look at this guy! Oh my, here he is! Let's get started. So the first thing you're gonna need is a bowl, a large bowl. And I'm going to put the recipe below in the description box on how I make it, in case you want to make it. Maybe that bunny's hanging out in your yard and you want to catch him. Who knows? So the first thing we're going to put in this bowl is 2 cups of Cheerios. And I'm just using the regular Cheerios. So I'm going to put them in. Okay. Aren't these little bunnies cute? I've had them for years. And if you didn't know better, you'd think they were real chocolate bunnies. They look just like chocolate. I love them. Whoopsie, bunny, we don't want to see your tail. Let's move you over. All right, the next I'm going to put in is 2 cups of Rice Chex. You know, the Rice Chex cereal. I'm going to put that in with the Cheerios. So that's 2 cups of that. I'm going to put in 1 cup of pretzel sticks. You can leave them whole or you can just, you know, cut them in half if you want. And you can double this recipe if you want to. But for now, I'm just going to make the single recipe. We're also going to put in there 1 cup of Easter M&Ms. Those are the pretty pink, yellow, green, purple, pastel ones. And put that in. So easy to make. And now I'm going to put in a handful of the Cadbury, a handful of the Cadbury mini eggs. So I'm going to put those in. So I have those ingredients in. I'm going to take a wooden spoon and just mix them all up. Okay. Now, we're going to need some white chocolate. And if you want, you can also add, you can throw in here another cup of another kind of cereal if you like it. You could put in a cup of Wheat Chex, or maybe you just want to put in, I don't know, throw in maybe a few peanuts. I don't really want to do that because there's a lot of people that have peanut allergies. But you can add another cup of something else you like. I saw they have a limited edition now of Cheerios. I saw them in the food store yesterday that are heart-shaped. So I thought they were kind of cute. Also, what I did purchase, do you know Annie's makes those little cookies and they're in the shape of bunnies? Now I saw they have like birthday cake ones out. I can't remember if they had carrot cake ones. They had a mixture of vanilla and chocolate in the box. So you can put those in there too. In fact, maybe I'll go grab a box of those now and I'll put a cup of those in just for fun. So stay tuned. So I do use these little Annie's bunnies for other things. So as you can see, these are the little bunny grams and these happen to be birthday cake ones. They have little speckles inside them, colored speckles. These are, I guess, fairly new for Easter. They're the Easter grams and they're strawberry shortcake. Mm-hmm. And the other box I have is Annie's Friends Bunny Graham. And they are chocolate chip and chocolate and honey. So what do you think I should put a cup of them in? I'm tempted to put the strawberry shortcake ones in, but maybe there's some people that don't like strawberry. I could put in these birthday cake ones with the little sprinkles. They would be pretty. Or should I put in the chocolate and the chocolate chip ones? What do you think? Maybe I'll put these in. So I think I'm going to probably put maybe a cup of these little bunny crackers in there. Perfect. They're so cute. Okay. So once you get all your ingredients in here, give them a little mix with a wooden spoon. All right. The next thing you're going to need is some white chocolate morsels. And I have here 16 ounces of the Giradelli white chocolate, you know, baking chips. You can use any brand you want. I'm going to melt this in the microwave. I'm going to do it at 30-second intervals, and I'm going to keep stirring so it doesn't burn. You don't want this to burn. You're going to be in big trouble. Take your eyes off it for a minute. Poof, it's burned. So anyway, then I'm going to take, while that's in the microwave, I'm going to take some parchment paper, and I'm going to take a big strip of it out, and I'm going to put it down here on my island. You don't have an island, put it on your kitchen table on my island while I melt my chocolate. So what are all of you doing for Easter? We're still involved in this pandemic, so a lot of people are just doing nothing. They're just staying home with their immediate families. We just have immediate family coming here. Nothing special. I'm gonna just do a ham and a few side dishes. What I am gonna make though is stuffed Italian artichokes. Oh, the angels are singing. I haven't made those in so long. I love them. My husband loves them. Even my grandson Kyle loves them. My son, who else? I think my son-in-law. I'm not sure if my daughter eats them. The little kids don't. The younger kids don't really like them, but except for Kyle. But we'll see. I think I'll give everybody a treat and make the stuffed artichokes. So let me get these morsels in the microwave. Let me know in the comments what you think you're doing for Easter. And if you're cooking, what are you making? And I should say now, while I'm heading over to the microwave, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, go down below and hit that red subscribe. And there's a little bell next to it. And you just hit that till it says all. And you will get a notification of any new videos I have coming up. You won't miss any. And it's free. So here I go over the microwave. Don't go away. I'll be right back. I don't believe it. While my white chocolate morsels are melting in the microwave, I saw something out of the corner of my eye, and look what I saw. That bunny. He's looking through my front window. Now he comes out during the day, too. Ooh, I'm going to get him.
Oh, my gosh. Look. Now he's peeping in my back door. Oh, this little guy. What a peeping Tom.
Something. Every year, since my grandsons, and I have four of them, were little, I have dressed as the Easter Bunny. I'll insert a couple of pictures there so you can see the cray-cray diva, what she looks like. I'll tell you, one year I had surgery, and I was hobbling around with a walker, and I still dressed as the bunny, and I went outside to greet my grandsons when they came with my bunny suit and my walker, and people were driving down the street waving and beeping at me. I like to have fun. I like to think I'm young at heart, even though I'm not young. What I like to do with this bunny bake mix is, besides catching Easter bunnies, and that maybe that's why the bunny's coming here, because I dress as the bunny. Coming, thinks I'm the bunny's friend, coming to visit me, I don't know. But besides putting them out on your dessert table or just having them as a snack, these are great, you'll see, after we break them up, to put them in little cellophane bags. You can tie a ribbon on it and curl it, and you can put them by everybody's place setting. You can put them in Easter baskets. You can give them to kids or give them to adults. And I think it's an easy to make fun little Easter treat. Now, I think this is melted. Let me just make sure I don't want to have any of the lumps in there. There we go. Now, you do not need this for the recipe, but I picked it up. Aren't these beautiful? I don't know if you can see the colors. These are Easter sprinkles. There's pink, green, white in there, pretty spring colors. They have little, like, I don't know, tiny chocolate balls in there. I actually found them in the bakery department of Stop and Shop. What they do a lot is they sell the container, and I guess it's what they use when they do their baking, and then they sell them in larger quantities. I think this was something like $3.99, I'm not sure, for this big container. So it's a lot more cost effective than you just, you know, if you buy those little jars. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my bowl, have everything mixed through, and I'm going to pour my melted chocolate into this mixture. And then with my wooden spoon, I'm going to gently turn it until everything is coated. Woo! Look at that yumminess. Here we go. Alrighty. Get all of that scooped out of there. Work quickly because, you know, chocolate does harden. Now take your wooden spoon and just gently get all of that mixture coated with the white chocolate. Looking good. Looking good. Looking good, Diva. So as you can see, I'm mixing all of this. I want to get everything coated. All right. How you doing, Diva? Getting everything done, Diva? Okay, I think so. All right. So now, let me move this. I have my parchment paper here. I hope it's close enough for you to see it. I'll move it in. And I'm going to now, here, bunny, you go here and hold that down. You go here and hold that then. Okay. I'm going to spoon it onto the parchment paper. Just like this. And then I'm going to spread it out in a row. You don't want a big pile of it. You want to spread it out. And what's going to happen is you don't have to put sprinkles on this at all. But if you are going to put a few on there, you know, just for color, You have to do it while this chocolate is still wet. Otherwise, it's not going to stick. Because melted chocolate, I always tell everyone, serves as a glue. You want to stick something on something? That made sense. Something on something. Use melted chocolate. Okay, back there. Almost everything out of here. This down here. All right. So as you can see, I'm going to take my wooden spoon and just move this around a little bit. You want to flatten it out a little bit. There we go. And I'm going to put a few sprinkles on there just for color. There we go. Look at that. Looking good. Looking good, Diva. Move these Cheerios over here. Okay. And this isn't a new recipe. I've made this before. It's been around the block a few times. What I like about it is you can make it for different holidays. You know, M&Ms come in all colors. For different holidays, you just switch up the colors of the M&Ms. And you can, switch up the sprinkles on it. And there you go. All right. So I'm going to leave that like that. And because it's still wet, I'm going to sprinkle some of these spring color sprinkles on here. They won't stick a lot, but they'll stick to some of the chocolate that's still wet. It just looks pretty. There you go. And that's all that's to it. Now we're gonna let this sit out here probably for a couple hours because you want the chocolate to harden. So once the chocolate hardens, look at that. Once the chocolate hardens, we're gonna come back because then we're gonna be able to break this with our hands into pieces. And I'm gonna put a plate out to catch the bunny. And I'm not sure if I wanna put mine in little plastic bags for the kids' baskets or if I just wanna put like a tin of it out on the table. So stay tuned while we do our breaking up and our taste testing. Don't go away. Okay, everybody, I'm back. So it took about an hour for the white chocolate to harden. Once it hardens, what you can do is break this up in pieces. So right now I happen to have this cute little carrot basket I'm gonna put it in. And I also have this little bowl I'm gonna put it in for the bunny. So what you just do is you break it up like this in pieces, and you can put them out on a platter like this, or like I mentioned, you can put them in little baggies and put them out as little treats. And I'm gonna taste a little piece now. See how I like it. Good. The combination of sweet and salty. You have a few pretzels in there. The Cheerios are not sweetened. And then you have your sweet things in there. If you wanted a little more salty, you can add some peanuts in instead of a little bunny cookies. It's really up to you. Very good. So I'm going to put these little pieces in here. And oh, wait a minute. Before I do, you must be all asking yourself. I put the other little dish out for the bunny. You must be asking yourself, did she catch the bunny with her bunny bait? Well, let me see. Yes, wait, the bunny wants to eat it. The bunny's eating it, oh no. Well, anyway, yes, bunny. Look at that cameraman bunny. Okay, you had enough, you're gonna get tummy ache. All right, well look, I caught the bunny and he said, wait, what? Wait, he's saying something.
Sure.
He said to tell everybody, wait, what? He said to tell everybody, happy Easter, and he'll see you next week. Okay, so I'm gonna break this up. I'm gonna put it in my dish. I'm gonna have a little snack. Maybe the bunny, I'll give him a little bit off camera. Sorry, my parrot is squeaking. But anyway, if I don't see any of you, happy Easter, but I hope I will because we have new Easter goodies coming up this week. So for now, I'm gonna eat my bunny bait and I'll see you all very soon. Toodles!